seen problems with bike lanes. Other towns were using differently, for example, there are two towns coming together all the time in the web page, but some towns do not come together all the time. For example, Wood and Wood come together with a similar meaning, but other words do not. So they find out that there is an evolution of words and their forms, the utilization of forms can get changed. And maybe because of that, the sense of particle may change or may not change. Maybe there was a typo which changed. It happened in New York Times, there was a typo, and New York Times has changed the typo. The sense was not changed, but there was a change. So they just pointed it out, and divergence from the norm, they just pointed it out, some of the terms. So they say avoid problem caused by the change. Because of change, we have to cache some information. For example, we have used internet previously, it was caching, and if the page changed, and it was recalling the previously cached information, you were dissatisfied. Right? So this may help if you can predict the change, it will bring something for better caching. So there are other applications that come to archiving and so on. Definitely, if you know about it, if you know when it is expected to change, only then you can recrawl that thing. So you do not keep on crawling every day for every incident, because for search engine it's very important to give up-to-date information to the one who is querying the search engine, right? For that purpose, they recrawl internet website very quickly. So if you know when you can expect a change, then you can have a policy of recall, right? So use to change to our advantage here. Because of change, ranking methodologies also changes, mapping terms, staying power. So there are few terms that stay on the website and few terms get changed. Those terms that stay on the website actually define that website, right? For example, on Geo stays there, right? Other things may fade away. Geo is a very powerful term for the search engine for finding a Geo website. It is representative of change. From one perspective, it is important for the search engine, and for the other, which I defined earlier, for the user, right? Because user wants to know what changed. If he doesn't want to know, maybe tomorrow he wants to. Because if we tell it's important, we will think, yeah. So, for example, this Tom and possibly the name of the person, maybe it's representative of this article in Wikipedia, and the rest of the article may change because of that. So, if somebody is searching for this, these three terms are very reflective of this web page, right? Because even you can see. You see that this article Tom Bosley made there, while the rest say the same. Bosley was very important So revisits are important when user revisits as I defined earlier. That is the point when user is in the search. What can Microsoft do with this? Can they facilitate user? Yes, they can. If they have a browser, such as app, and it force user to allow the change. So there is one stress on your eye, your mind, to study the change happening. Right? So if they give you this facility, you're bound to stay more on internet for the control or other habits. And on the other side, the second benefit is also for the search engine, crawling efficiency, all the things that they know about change. They may not recall that a page which does not change often, they can have a black box. So, what's the last web page you visited? I mean, which version of the page? For example, you visited Yahoo's web page 4 days back. So, change would be calculated from 4 days, not from previous days. Because user is interested in what he saw in general, right? Log analysis, you can have log inside your system, rather log in the studio for refining your system. So, you can facilitate user by studying them and giving them permission. Summary, unique visitor, right? I'll just skip because you understand. So, they have some ways to calculate the histogram of how much time it takes to change. It's not that important. If you want to study, then read that in the paper. I can give you the paper. What I want to give you through these slides is an introduction or feeling how people are using this area of interest for professional use. If you can understand or you can find interest in this kind of area of research, you can definitely do meaningful activities with such kind of things. So maybe we can say there are some kind of pages which are fast and jaded, and revisits are fast, such as C, hybrid, not that fast, medium, slow. You can see the example. For example, somebody is interested in some kind of theme pictures, very commonly, they are giving to some kind of business, right? So, he is a designer or something, right? So, for him, maybe a change for that is faster, because click art gets populated with pictures very commonly. So, maybe for that, this is what's important. Hybrid information could be some other websites, which are the products. Medium would be such as popular pages such as Amazon. Amazon does not change that popularly and the car of the slow would be sort of some big sluggish website. Maybe your team network home page or something like that. Or mobile internet world. Sluggish page. Or maybe you access it via search engine very rarely. For that, it's not important, and you do not even read it. The user revisits, for example, what he searched by search engine, he does not revisit it. Very often. So we can predict revisit metrics by this metric. Medium, we say home pages, but there are some websites where he wants to. For example, in our case, maybe fastest change is okay. We visit that very often. It's very important. These kind of metrics they took into consideration in order to have a statement of about possible future IE so parameters. So they say there are repeated queries, but I mean there was some study in web science conference that people provide repeated queries on the search engine. For example, you want to find out about some website very often, but you don't remember the address of the IE Google. New queries are 57% according to their stats. Similarly, repeated clicks, when you search for something, such as website content, you go and click. Very commonly, 39% when you go to the repeated click, when you type in something. So this all gives lots of people. This, what does this give? When you search for something, there is a change. Then that change should be reported to the user. The last time, for example, you search website, which is the result was like that, now the result changes. Maybe you violated it. But it was there, now it's there, now it's there. It's there, for example. So, the web is over there, still the same web address as previous, you see. Right? No, the web address is changed. So this is, even this came up as a top. So it can tell the user what you previously searched has been replaced by this popular user. Maybe it's important. They are just thinking it's not yet a design